friends, I am Dr. Syed Khadiruddin Chishti and I am teaching physics to the BSc third year students. My today's topic is Stark effect. Now we studied about the Zeeman effect, and in this Zeeman effect we applied the external magnetic field to a spectral line and it get splitted into the several components because of the strong magnetic field as well as because of the weak magnetic field. Now if I apply an electric field to an spectral line, then it also get splitted into the several components. We know very well about the hydrogen spectrum, that when in the hydrogen spectrum, when an electron jumps from the higher orbit to the first orbit, then there is origin of the spectral line known as the Lyman series. Then there is, when an electron jumps to the second orbit, then there is Balmer series. Then there is Paschen series, Fund series, Brackett series in the hydrogen atom, which we studied already. Lyman series, when the electron jumps from the higher orbit to the first orbit in case of hydrogen atom. And Balmer series, which is only known as the visible series, when electron jumps from the higher orbit to the second orbit. That is, in the hydrogen atom, when n is equal to 2, n1 is equal to 2 and n2 is equal to 3, means 3, 4, 5 and so on, then it is known as the Balmer series. In Balmer series, we are having the H alpha line, H beta line, H delta line and so on, H gamma line and so on. So the Stark said that the splitting of every line of the Balmer series, remember here, Balmer series, the splitting of every line of the Balmer series of hydrogen atom in a strong electric field is called as the Stark effect. The electric field is of the order of 10 to power 5 volt per centimeter. It is a very high electric field. So such type of phenomenon is called as the Stark effect, and the every line of the Balmer series get splitted into the several line. If I take the example of first line of the Balmer series, that is n equal to 2, n1 equal to 2 and n2 equal to 3, that is called as the H alpha line. Then for H alpha line, it get divided into five parts, 1 line, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this spectrum is for n equal to 2, n1 equal to 2 and n2 equal to 3, means the orbits, from the suborbits also the electron will jump to the lower orbits. So there will be 5 lines because of the high electric field. Similarly, when I take the example of the H beta line, then on both the sides of the H beta line there is a series of the lines known as the sigma series and known as the pi series, means the splitting of the lines, spectral lines, will continue on both the sides from the different orbits of the hydrogen atom. So such type of splitting can be seen through when the spectrometer is parallel to the magnetic field and when the position of spectrometer is perpendicular to the magnetic field. When I place the spectrometer parallel, then sigma components are unpolarized. Sigma component are unpolarized, but the pi component will be absent. Pi component will be absent. And when I see the spectrometer perpendicular to the magnetic field, then both sigma and pi components become polarized. And it is given by, and the energy or the spectral lines are proportional to the electric field E. So it can be given by the equation delta T is equal to AE plus BE square plus C cube and so on, where A, B, C are the arbitrary constants. And E is electric field vector. So for the first series, we can say that delta T is proportional to the E. For, it means that delta T is equal to AE. It is known as the first order Stark effect. when delta t is equal to ae plus be square, it is called as a second order Stark effect, and so on, we can say. And the splitting of the line, for example, number of lines in H alpha series, H alpha line, will be less than the number of splitting lines in H beta. It means that there will be more splitting of the lines will take place in H beta line. Means H beta has large number of the lines as compared to the H alpha line after the application of the electric field. Similarly, H gamma line has more number of splitting line than the H beta as well as H alpha. And H delta line has the highest number of the electric, highest number of the lines. Okay, so this is known as the Stark effect. Thank you.